Let me tell you about the power supply that takes place in our homes. Now this power supply is first starting from the power plant. At the power plant, electricity is produced at a particular voltage. Now this electricity has to travel long distances because the power plant is usually situated very far away from cities. So in order to travel these long distances, the voltage will have to be increased for transportation. Now this increase of voltage takes place at a particular point. At this point, the voltage is increased to a point in the order of kilovolts. That is a very, very high voltage, few thousands of kilovolts. Now from this point, it reaches a distribution line. Now at this distribution line or the distribution station, it ensures that this electricity travels to different parts of the city. Now in the city, there are again various sections. Now before this electricity reaches our homes, there is another point where the voltage will have to be decreased. Why? Because if this high voltage were to be supplied directly to our homes, it would not only cause fatalities, it would also damage any appliance connected to this high voltage. So at this point, the voltage is reduced. Now, when the voltage is reduced, from here, the electricity goes to the distribution lines for a particular neighborhood. And from there, the electricity reaches our homes at this decreased voltage. So in India, this decreased voltage has a fixed value. The main supply is about 220 volts in India. So we can say that 220 volts is the voltage at which we get electricity. Now you might be wondering that how this 220 volt can run all appliances at our homes. Let us say, for example, a doorbell. A doorbell needs no more than 6 volts. However, as you might be knowing, this doorbell runs on the same electricity on which certain other appliances run. Let's say a television. Now, a television requires several thousand volts. Now, we see that a doorbell requiring 6 volts and a television requiring several thousand volts, both are running on a main supply of 220 volts. But how is this possible? And not only those appliances, certain other appliances, let's say like a hairdryer or a mobile charger, all these appliances have different operational voltages. So how is it that all these appliances can be run at the same voltage of 220 volts that we get in our mains? Let us find out. In order to do this, an instrument known as the transformer is used. What is the purpose of a transformer? The basic purpose of a transformer is that an EMF of an alternating current can be increased or decreased. Or in other words, if we have a certain EMF of an alternating current, it means that that EMF can either be increased with the help of the transformer or decreased. Notice that it is important to remember that it is only the EMF of an alternating current that can be changed, and we shall soon find out why it is so. So this is the basic construction of a transformer. As you can see, we have a core which contains a primary side and a secondary side. Now on the primary side, a wire is wound around the core, as you can see. Across this, the primary voltage, or the voltage that needs to be changed to a desired value, is applied. And on the opposite side of the core, we have the secondary side. Now on the secondary side also, the wire is wound, and across it, we obtain the secondary voltage, or the desired voltage that we require from the primary voltage. So now let us find out how the transformer functions. In this animation, you will find that a certain voltage of alternating nature is applied on the primary side. As you can see, the current is reversing its direction after a certain period of time. Now, due to this change in current direction as well as magnitude, because it is alternating current, there is an induced EMF that is produced on the secondary side. So now let us find out why the transformer works only in the case of alternating current but not in the case of direct current. Now we have studied about Hans Christian Oersted's discovery, the discovery that stated current carrying conductor produces a magnetic field around it, and we have also studied about the reverse phenomenon, that due to a change in magnetic flux, it is possible to create an EMF, thereby creating a current, which is known as the induced EMF or induced current. So the primary coil in the transformer produces a magnetic field because current flows through it. Due to this reason, we can say that the current flowing through the primary coil varies. Why? Because we are using an alternating current. Now, due to this reason, a varying magnetic field will be produced. A varying magnetic field means that the magnitude of the magnetic field varies according with time. So due to the fact that a varying current flows through the primary coil, a varying magnetic field is produced. Now due to this, the magnetic field lines linked with the secondary coil change. We have studied earlier that the strength of a magnetic field is given by the density of its magnetic field lines. So more the number of magnetic field lines in a given space, more will be its strength, and less the number of magnetic field lines, less will be its strength. So we can find that a varying magnetic field means the number of field lines linked with the secondary coil is changing. This is the reason that a particular EMF in the secondary coil will be produced, because of the fact that magnetic field lines linked with the secondary coil change. Thus we have an EMF that is induced in the secondary coil due to the presence of an alternating EMF in the primary coil. Now this is exactly the reason why direct current cannot be used. In direct current, the direction of current remains constant in a particular direction, and so does the magnitude. So if the current that is flowing does not vary, it means that a varying magnetic field will not be produced. If a varying magnetic field is not produced, it means there will be no change in magnetic flux linked with the secondary coil, and the entire purpose of a transformer will be defeated. This is the reason why only alternating current is used on the primary side in order to obtain an alternating EMF on the secondary side. So this voltage that we obtain by applying a particular voltage on the primary side is obtained on the secondary side and is known as the secondary voltage. Now the secondary voltage that we obtain at the secondary side depends on two things. The first thing that it depends on is the magnitude of EMF applied in the primary coil. So higher the magnitude of the EMF applied on the primary coil, more will be the magnitude of the EMF applied on the secondary coil. But this is not the only factor that the magnitude depends on. The magnitude of induced EMF depends on one more thing. That one more thing is the ratio of the number of turns in the secondary coil to the number of turns in the primary coil, or in other words, NS by NP. So the relation which guides a transformer is this, that states that EMF across the secondary coil divided by EMF across the primary coil is equal to number of turns in the secondary coil divided by number of turns in the primary coil. So let's say that we have a given primary voltage which we need to change according to our needs. So we will also know what the change voltage we require is, and accordingly we can decide what will be the number of turns in the secondary coil and the number of turns in the primary coil. So based on the number of turns in the primary and secondary, and also the voltage that is developed at the secondary side, we can classify transformer under two heads. Firstly, we come to a step-up transformer. In a step-up transformer, what happens? It converts a low voltage alternating EMF to a high voltage alternating EMF. Or in other words, if we apply EP, that is low, and we want to change it to ES, This ES will be of a higher voltage than EP. So this means that ES divided by EP is greater than 1. This implies that since ES by EP is greater than 1, NS by NP is also greater than 1, or in other words, NS is greater than NP. So in order to construct a step-up transformer, we need to ensure that the number of turns in the secondary coil are greater than the number of turns in the primary coil. And the exact number of turns will depend on what amount of secondary voltage we need. So this is what a step-up transformer looks like. As you can clearly see, we have less number of turns on the primary side and more number of turns on the secondary side. So let's say we are applying 110 or 120 volts of an alternating nature on the primary side, and if we step it up to a particular value of, let's say, 220 or 240 volts, what does this mean? This means that ES by EP can be given by, let's consider 120 and 240. ES is 240 divided by EP, that is 120, and this gives us 2. So this implies that the ratio in between the number of turns in the secondary and number of turns in the primary should be equal to 2:1. Similarly, we have a step down transformer. Converse to what a step up transformer is, a step down transformer converts high voltage alternating EMF to low voltage alternating EMF. So if we apply a particular value of EP, then the desired value of ES that we need is lesser than this value of EP. So this implies that ES by EP is less than 1. This also implies that NS by NP will be less than 1, and thus NS will be less than NP. This means that the number of turns in the secondary coil will be less than the number of turns in the primary coil. So now over here we have a step down transformer. As you can clearly see, the number of turns in the primary coil are much more than the number of turns in the secondary coil. So if we use the same formula again, let us see what we come up with. I again consider ES by EP. So over here ES is 120 volts, let us consider, and EP is, let's consider, 240 volts. So this means 1/2, and this implies that the ratio in between the number of turns in the secondary coil to the number of turns in the primary coil will have to be 1:2. So thus we find that there are two kinds of transformers which can be used. In case of the power supply to our homes, we found that initially voltage was being increased, so we used a step up transformer, and before supplying to our homes, that same voltage was decreased. That meant we were using a step down transformer.